Hi, my name is Denver Riddle, and I'm your host at Color Grading Central. I'm really excited to demonstrate the awesome power of the brand new DaVinci Resolve 9. If you're not familiar with DaVinci, then it's worth noting that it's been used on more feature films and television spots than any other color grading system. And if that's not enough, once costing in the hundreds of thousands of dollars, it's now available for free in the light version or with the purchase of the Blackmagic Digital Cinema Camera. So I highly recommend that you try it out, and if you'd like to learn more, you can click on the link below in the description of the video. Now, I'm going to share with you some really powerful grading techniques as we explore the new Resolve 9. The first thing you'll notice is that the interface has been completely redesigned. This was the major focus in this update, and you'll see that all of the functions have been consolidated into 5 pages, making the interface more intuitive and user-friendly. The pages also follow a project-based workflow from left to right, starting with the importing of media, conforming, color grading, and final delivery. Projects now can also be saved into a project file and shared. So let's jump right in and do some color grading, and I'll further explain the interface as we go along. Here in the color page, I have a normal looking flat image. I'd like to add the dragon effect since I think it'd be a really cool look for this shot. If you've never heard of the dragon effect, it's named after the Polish photographer Andrzej Dragon, and you may have seen this look finding its way into moving images. I first need to add some contrast to the image, so we can do that in the primaries palette. You'll see that the primaries palette has all the primary controls consolidated into one section. I'm excited to introduce you to the new log grading feature in Resolve 9. We'll find it under the color wheels tab where we have the traditional three-way, and then under the drop-down menu, we'll choose log. In log mode, we have increased control over the tonal range. The low range and high range controls allow us to set the threshold or the cutoff point for the shadows and highlights respectively. This is best demonstrated. I'll go ahead and make a correction to the shadows, and then adjust the low range. This lets me precisely define the point where the shadows in the image are affected by my correction. Then I'll do the same in the highlights. There. Now with the primary correction complete, we can begin creating the look. The dragon effect is characterized by a lot of contrast, so I'll add a new node. By the way, if you don't know what a node is, Resolve is a nodal-based color corrector where each node represents an adjustment or correction. So like for in this instance, we'll use the new node to add contrast. And to do that, I'll use another new feature of the log mode, and that is this convenient contrast control. With one single control, we can add contrast to the image. Then we can adjust the pivot point, or the center point, from which the contrast is based. Let's see the before and after to see how far we've come. It's already beginning to look better. Now we need to add some focus and sharpening to just the face. Starting in a new node, I'll add a shape or a power window to his face. We'll find the power window in the middle palette here. You can see the Power Windows interface has been redesigned and is more intuitive. I'll select the circular power window and position it over the talent's face. Now we can make the correction. I'll bring up the exposure on his face. And then to add sharpening, I'll click on the blur tab, then select sharpen in the dropdown, and then add some sharpening. To continue with our focusing, I'll also add an outside node and bring down the exposure surrounding the face. I'll also lower the saturation a little too. Now it's likely that the camera or the talent will move, so we'll need to track the window. Jumping to the previous node with the window, we'll find the tracker now here in the same palette instead of in a different page. I'll click the forward track button and watch as the amazing world-class 3D tracker automatically tracks the shape. You'll also see that we have this new graph that allows us to visually interact with the tracking data. Really cool, isn't it? So let's now take a look at the final before and after, and play this back for you. With Resolve, it's really easy to create cool effects like the dragon effect. Moving on to our next clip, I want to give it a sort of post-apocalyptic look. I'll begin by giving it contrast. But first let me bring up the scopes so we can see them while we work. You'll notice that the scopes have been redesigned and offer 1-up, 2-up, and 4-up configurations. Personally, I like to work from the parade scope and vector scope. Now I'll add contrast under the log mode. Now we can begin creating the look. In a new node, I want to give it that sort of grungy bleach bypass look, so I'll do that by making a luma curve adjustment. Under the Curves tab, a really neat new feature is that I can bring up the Curves editor in magnified form. With the curves ungained, I'll make a luma curve adjustment. In another node, I'll lower the saturation. Now I'm ready to add a color effect. I'll use the Curves editor to create the look that I'm going for. Give me just a moment while I make the adjustment. I think that looks good. Now, I want to do something about the sky, so I'll show you a really cool technique. In a new node, I'll first pull an isolation on it using the color picker under the qualifier tab. And then add a rectangular shape. I'll position it like so and add some softening to the bottom to give it a gradient effect. Now we're ready to make the correction. So I'll lower the midtones a little bit and push the midtones and highlights towards a cyan color. There's the difference that made. Okay, now, I want to add a couple finishing touches. Under the Curves tab, I want to make some Hue Curves adjustments. Going to the Hue vs. Saturation, I want to increase the saturation in the warm colors, so I'll do that by clicking the red vector button and pulling up on the point. This will only increase the saturation of the warm colors. Then for stylized reasons, I want to make the car more of a cherry red color as opposed to fire engine red. Under the Hue vs. Hue control, I can do this. I'll simply add a point to the curve by clicking on the car. There, with the point added, I'll just pull up on it a little bit. And voila! Here's the before and after. Now the playback. And you'll notice, even with all of those corrections being made, that it still plays back in real time. In our last clip, I want to demonstrate perhaps one of the most powerful features of Resolve, and that is the use of power grades. Power grades are stored grades that you can save and call upon later. Colorists have their own library of looks, and Resolve 9 even comes packaged with a collection of looks. To use them, just simply make your basic correction, and then under the gallery palette, pick a grade, right-click, and choose Append Node Graph. What this does is apply the grade after your correction, and you can even go in and make adjustments to the look or use the Key Tab feature to dial back elements of the look until it suits your taste. Here's, for example, a few of my Luster Power grades. I have grades for imitating popular film looks, certain film stocks and emulsions, and even some vintage looks. Power grades are a really powerful feature in Resolve that allow you to save your looks and quickly give you ideas. In conclusion, I hope that this demonstration has been helpful, and I invite you to try out the powerful new Resolve 9. If you'd like to learn more, just click on the link in the description, and if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comments. Thank you for watching.